Oh, slow night. Summer comedy.
We got one more comic coming to the stage, unless anybody else would like to sign up for open mic comedy tonight. Like I said, this is open mic every week, except on occasion we have feature shows such as next week I will be recording a live album here. Yeah. Come check that out. In the meanwhile, welcome your last comic, unless anybody else would like to sign up. If you would like to sign up, come see me and welcome to the stage, my friend indeed, the former greatest homeless comedian in Huntsville, Alabama, Mr. Joel Elliott.
Oh, God. Actually, you know, it's funny that he calls me that former homeless comedian, because as our audience poll, quick audience poll. First of all, quick audience poll. How many of you knew that I wore glasses? Round of applause. Did you know I wear glasses? Round of applause. Nobody? Okay. How many of you knew that I've been homeless for the last 4 months? Round of applause. Yeah, this guy. He's the only one. I didn't play it up this time because I was just garden variety homeless, you know? Like, people have been letting me live indoors, you know? It's not like I've been living on the street. I was street homeless back when I was the number one homeless comedian. But, yeah, no, I have been for reals. It's true. I've been homeless for the last 4 months. It's not true that I wear glasses. I found these in the gutter. That, because them's the rules. If you leave your foster grants in the gutter, they're mine. That's how that works. They make me feel fancy, okay? I'm homeless. I don't have a lot of things going for me in my life. If I find a pair of Foster Grants, I don't even know. Are Foster Grants girls' glasses? I don't even know. I remember on the commercial, it was like Cheryl Teagues, or it was some older lady celebrity, and she was like, I always feel special in my Foster Grants. I don't remember what the slogan was. I keep meaning to look it up on YouTube, but then I realized, you know, it'd be more fun if I just keep making it up, you know, like... My erections last longer when I'm wearing my Foster Grants. I'm just gonna just make up a new one every time I put them on, you know? Like, Black Lives Matter because Foster Grant. You know, I don't know. I'm just making it up every time. But yeah, no, I've been homeless for the last 4 months, you see, because I was working for a software company, I was paying rent, everything was fine. Then I started beefing with this guy named Dale Jackson. I know what you're thinking. Dale who? Exactly. Exactly. Who the hell is that guy? He's like this one of those conservative talk show hosts. His whole image is the attack machine, you know? Like, okay, like when we had that little kerfuffle with people getting upset and scared that Black Lives Matter was gonna, like, overturn buses during the protest, he was the guy that was spreading that rumor that the Black Lives were violent, you know? Dale, this insecure son of a bitch who's on radio and... Anyway, I was beefing with Dale, and that was back in March, my boss and I had started to kind of, you know, have trouble communicating, and she used to sleep with the guy, and so it's like, you know, itty-bitty city committee, I got fired. You know, politics. You gotta watch who you beef with in this town, because there's ripples. It sends ripples out. Anyway, I lost my job in March, and I have not been able to pay rent for like 4 months. I have been living just way on the fringe of society for 4 months. But I want to make an announcement today. Okay, first of all, I did get a job. I'm doing a caretaking thing. I'll talk about that in a second. But as of tonight, I just got the word. I was going to end up homeless August 1st, but no, I'm living somewhere now. I'm no longer homeless, guys. Yes, I'm going to live in a place, and I'm going to pay for living there like people do. Instead of just... My plan C was to just go back to the street and, like, vlog until somebody gave me a home. Like, that was my plan, but thank God we didn't end up doing that. That was going to be odd. Actually, it might be good for my YouTube views. Maybe I should just turn that thing down, you know, like, not go to the apartment and do that, but... Yeah, no, so I'm going to be living indoors, which is good, because, it's Alabama. I keep feeling like if the temperature gets, like, 2 degrees hotter, the National Guard is going to come and, like, bring us all a case of Gatorade and, like, move us to a more hospitable climate. It's horrible around here. People shouldn't live in this area of the country, not because of the institutionalized racism, the climate. Because it's this way all over the country. You know, like, metropolitan areas are racist, too. They're just quieter about it. You know, like, they're not quite so roll-tide about, you know, being superior to other people. Oh, Alabama. Oh, God. The worst thing happened to me this morning. You guys want to hear about that? I woke up in Alabama. It's been happening for like 900 consecutive days, but it freaks me out every time. Like, I mean, I've been mentally ill for my entire life, so like, it's not like a surprise when I wake up and I'm filled with existential dread, but every time that I wake up and I'm in Alabama, the existential dread is just, it's got like a twang on it, you know? Like, it's like, I don't know why I'm here, you know? Like, I used to grow up waking up thinking, I don't know why I'm here. Or I guess in Baltimore, it would be like, I don't know why I'm here, huh? And, you know, whatever. I know. But now I just, I wake up every day and I'm wondering why. Why did this happen again? Why am I still here? But that's why I'm perfectly suited for this job that I took. I'm caretaking for somebody with dementia. And like my entire, you know, online personality, my entire persona is all about mental health. And so now I'm doing this caretaking position for somebody with dementia, and it works because every time that she freaks out and has one of those moments where she's like, I just want it to be over. I just, let me go. I know she doesn't mean let me, like, leave me alone. She means, like, let me go and die now. You know, like, she's just expressing dissatisfaction with existing. And every time she does that, I'm like, I know. You know what? I know. I feel the same way, but like, I'm not gonna help you die, and I have to lift you up and in and out of the bed, so I know that you're not gonna help me die. So like, since neither of us are going to kill ourselves right now, why don't you take the rest of your medication? Because this is gonna make you feel better. And she respects this. Like, she gets the fact that I am serious when I agree with her that nobody should be alive. This is a horrible world. Life is pain and suffering. Yes, I know. I want to go too. We all want to go. But we're not going to do it. So let's find something to do. Do you want to go outside? Do you want me to get the cat? I'll poke the cat for you if you want. I'm just saying, caretaking for a dementia patient is going pretty well because we are way on the same level. I got heckled tonight by somebody with dementia. Like, no crap. I was rolling her back to her bed, okay? And it's like she could tell that I was making a joke, and she rejected it soundly. Like, I was saying to her, like, hey, thanks for sitting up tonight. Because, like, yesterday when I was watching her, she stayed in bed the whole time. And I like spending time with her. I enjoy that. And so I told her, hey, thank you for sitting up tonight. Because, like, last night I was lonely, and I like spending time with you. And your son, I mean, you know, he's a nice guy, but, like, he's nothing compared to you. And she was like, nah. You know, like, I just got heckled by her. She was like, that's not funny. You're stupid. If I can't make somebody with dementia laugh, then I really need to quit this game, because I am clearly losing at life. Oh, God. I'm winning at Twitter. I'm winning at Twitter, and I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why I'm winning at Twitter, because I've been getting a lot of feedback lately. Somebody recently told me, go home, fag. That's how you know you're really reaching people. Like, I'm reaching people on the other side of the divide if their response to the things that I say about equality and tolerance are go home, fag. Somebody called me an anti-Semite and a Jew in the same tweet. And, like, I don't even get, like, nothing I was saying had anything to do with anti-Semitism. Somebody, I was fighting with a troll the other day, and I posted the screenshot from Always Sunny in Philadelphia from that troll toll part of the musical, you know, where Danny DeVito is dressed as a troll. And, like, somebody got all my crap. He was like, that's Shylock. That's Shylock, the misrepresentation of Jewish people. That's Shylock. And I it just kept going on. And I was like, no, it's a character from this thing. And he's like, no, that's Shylock. And so I had to call him out. I was like, don't be a dipshit, Chris. That's Danny DeVito from Always Sunny. Chris, don't be a dipshit. And it actually got through to him. I got through to a troll. The guy was like, oh, okay, you know what? I apologize for my mistake, and I'm sorry. And I was like, you know what, Chris? I'm sorry for being so strong-worded, but, like, listen to me when I explain things to you. I am actually that persistent online that I got to the end of a troll conversation today where the dude was like, dude was ending all his things with, like, you suck, go away, you suck, go away. And then he said something about how he doesn't subscribe to cod philosophy. And my response was, you know what, I wouldn't take any philosophy that comes from a fish. And his response to me was, okay, you know what, that was actually pretty funny, don't go away. I was like, all right, you know what? I won over the troll. That dude and I are friends now. We follow each other on Twitter. We're friends now. It's great. I fought with him for like 10 minutes, tweeting back and forth, and eventually he was like, you know what? Don't go away. I like you. That is why I feel there's hope in America. If I can win over the hearts of trolls, then maybe we won't kill each other by election day. Not likely. I'm pretty sure that there is going to be a mass, like, mutual genocide of Democrats and Republicans. But thank God I know how to survive on the street. All y'all fuckers are doomed. I'm gonna be out there, you know, eating canned food with a spoon, living my life alone in Alabama because all y'all killed each other over this damn election. Yeah, don't forget to vote, everybody. They're gonna have pitchforks and torches at the election places. I was worried that this was going to be a dead summer crowd, but you guys came to life for me, and I appreciate that, because as we went over earlier, there's really no point to existence, and we all should just give up. So thank you for defying the odds and coming to life and being with me tonight. This was so much fun. Maggie Myers, you have been great. I, on the other hand, have simply been...
Last comic of the evening, Joel Elliott, everybody.